Senator Gibson on the bill.
Thank you, Mr. President, for the opportunity to speak on this bill. There are some very good things in this bill that I am very happy about, and one of them is the Local Government Efficiency Grant Program. This program will allow local municipalities that are experiencing severe budget crunches. It will help them in reaching out for more opportunities to share services and making the entire process more streamlined, and it will, more importantly, speed up the process in which grant money is brought back to these local governments. I'm very happy to see that that is in here. I'm also happy to see that this adjudication of traffic violations has been changed from what the executive was originally proposing. The executive's proposal would have taken power away from our local governments. It would have taken power away from the ability for them to plea bargain tickets. This would have led to increase in trials, and the resulting expenses would have gone back to our local governments. This new solution will reduce local governments' traffic court expenses, and more importantly, it will continue an important stream of revenue for our local governments. These two things are good. However, in this bill, there is one thing that is particularly bad, and that is that the Beacon Correctional Facility, which is located in the southern end of my district, is proposed to be closed. As many of you know, I fought hard to keep this facility open, along with many of my colleagues. There are women there that receive valuable services that will be unfortunately displaced to other locations that will not be able to offer the quality of care that they were receiving there. Jobs are at stake, and more importantly, the local economy stands to suffer greatly from this decision. Having said that, apparently I'm left no other course of action than to try to find a way to make use of this outstanding facility, which is over 300 acres, right in the middle of a thriving metropolis, the city of Beacon. It's a great place to visit. If you haven't been there, I hope you'll come and see what they've done there on their own, with art galleries and restaurants. The education system there is growing. It's an exciting place to be. So what we have to do now is we have to find a way to revitalize this important venue there. And so I'm committed to working with the governor's office and the local community in finding a way to make sure that we develop good local jobs at this location and that we find a way to make sure that the economy continues to grow as a result of the work that we're doing there. And that's where my focus will be moving forward. As I said, there are good things in this bill that I support. But the fact that a facility that offered so many good services and such a great economic benefit to my district is being closed, I will have to vote no on this bill. Thank you, Mr. President.